your best friend in real estate investing? I've got one of mine, and we're going to talk about what he does and how he is your best friend when you're starting to get into a real estate investment position in this video. What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Uncle Mott in the building talking about one of my favorite topics, real estate. Y'all know that's my favorite investment vehicle. And today, the man that manages my vehicle, the one that keeps that Lamborghini oiled, keeps it from falling off the street, that runs that passive income machine that I have, is with me. He is Brent Morris. He's my property manager. He's a real estate investor himself. Mr. Brent, how you doing today?
I'm doing great.
Thank you for sitting down with me. I have a lot of people that wanted to know what is their first steps in getting into real estate investing. And they've heard my horror story with that commercial property I have because I didn't have someone like you to learn from. So I decided to bring him here for you guys to get to know who he is and hear his story. So first thing we want to know from you, how did you get started in real estate?
Well, I think I got started in real estate because I had a passion to improve my life. Mm-hmm. And I have a background as an engineer.
Okay.
I worked in corporate America for about 10 years and big companies you've probably heard of. And I wanted to generate some passive income.
Okay.
And so I got started in real estate by actually investing myself in some properties that I purchased, renovated, and then rented, and started my experience that way.
So did you, from that point, did you catapult into property management from managing your own properties? How did you get to the point where the property management came
in? Yeah, so you know, I obviously couldn't start a property management company at that point because I didn't know anything.
Right, right.
So after, you know, managing some tenants for a couple years, I went ahead and got my real estate license.
Okay.
Because in most states, you need to be licensed in order to manage other people's property.
Oh.
So I was able to do that. And then I saw a need in the marketplace. Mm-hmm. I felt like I was getting very proficient at it.
Okay.
And thought that maybe some others could benefit from what I had learned and what I was doing. And so I got started probably 3 to 4 years after getting my license and me starting my journey in investment real estate.
Gotcha. How long have you been in the realm of real estate or real estate investing, real estate, just either one? How long have you been in the realm?
It's been about 12 years. It's gone by very quickly.
Really?
Yeah, 12 years. And the economy was not in very good shape when I got started. So some people thought it was a little crazy to do it, but honestly, the best time to get started is probably right where you are.
Right, just got to dive in, you know.
You know, the economy ebbs and flows. Mm-hmm. A lot of factors that the average American just doesn't have control over.
Right.
But, you know, you'll hear people say there's a lot of cycles. You know, history repeats itself.
Mm-hmm.
There's cycles. And
right.
So, you know, you get some awesome opportunities. Sometimes you get some mediocre opportunities. But the key is to just get on base.
In order to get an opportunity, you got to get in.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You got to get in the game.
Right. Exactly.
You know, sometimes you get a home run, but you know, a lot of times you just get a single and keep driving the runs in.
Exactly. You hit on the point that real estate can be something that creates a lot of passive income.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Explain to me and my viewers, how has the passive income been a game changer in the real estate game for you?
Okay. So everybody knows active income. That's hours for dollars.
Exactly. You know, you're exchanging time for money, basically.
Not here to criticize that, but there are other opportunities out there. So passive income is any sort of asset that can generate income that is not necessarily time dependent.
Exactly.
So that's what got me excited about real estate, because being a engineer and having kind of an analytical mind, numbers mattered to me.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew I had limited time. And I knew I didn't want to work forever. And so, you know, I saw real estate as a vehicle that if you purchase an asset and it generated a certain amount of income, then that was exciting to me, because I wasn't necessarily spending as much time doing that and dealing with that than I would be at a full-time job.
Gotcha.
And so, you know, working full-time gave me the opportunity and some of the finances to be able to stick my toe into real estate. But definitely, you know, some people develop massive portfolios that they can retire on or just give them some additional options in life.
Right. So my channel, I've got people that watch me on every level of real estate investing.
Okay.
a lot of newbies,
yeah,
some seasoned veterans,
mm-hmm,
and then you've got people that we would say are very, very seasoned that okay. own portfolios 50 plus.
Great.
So this question is kind of directed for more of my newbies.
Okay.
Tell us how, for someone who's just getting into real estate, no matter if they're getting into, I guess, wholesaling, buying and flipping, or, you know, maybe they're just investing in some of the peer-to-peer real estate vehicles. I want you to explain to them how a property manager can be a benefit to them when they're first getting started.
Sure. Yeah, and I don't think I appreciated it in the beginning myself. And so it took me a while to realize the value, much less become one. But, you know, I think that property management is a service, and it is a profession. And so many times, like, a lot of people don't change their own oil in their car. You mentioned the Lamborghini a little while ago.
You're driving mine.
You know, it's like you don't change that oil yourself anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You know, can you? Yeah, you could probably get a YouTube video and learn how to do it.
You can.
You know, you could, you know, a lot of people don't cut their own grass anymore. You know,
yeah.
So a lot of things in life, you know, people are now to a point where they're wanting to hire an expert. They're wanting to outsource that component of work so they can focus on the things they really want to do.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I think that what a property manager can do for somebody is, one, give them some time.
Yep.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Because you're not dealing with the ins and outs and those crazy tenant stories you hear about from your friends, relatives, and neighbors. Right?
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. We all got that crazy uncle.
Some of them are true, but some of them have been embellished some.
Right.
But anyway, a property manager can give you expertise on the market, help you understand what a rent figure could be on a property.
Mm-hmm.
Because many times, as a real estate investor, that's really the critical piece.
I mean,
you might be able to buy it for this price, but if you thought you could get this number, but you missed a couple things and you can only get this number, that changes the whole game plan on if that really makes sense to you.
Right.
And then also keeping up with all the different nuances of law changes
The
local level, mm-hmm, state level, federal level, fair housing laws, different things that you need to follow, lead-based paint issues. You know, the
zoning, all kinds of
all sorts of things, and then just the screening component.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I can't tell you how many properties we have started to manage because the owner managed it themselves, and they had a good feeling,
mm-hmm,
from that person they rented to that never paid them a cent after they moved in.
Good Lord!
So you know, the screening process is really critical, and not everybody has the ability to pull a credit report,
mm-hmm,
pull a nationwide criminal check, nationwide eviction check, and to follow up on references and really prove that somebody is who they say they are and the documentation they provided is legitimate to where their future tenancy and paying ability is a good reflection based on their past and everything checks out. So
right.
Not everybody can even do that.
Certainly can't.
So
it's just to kind of expand on what you've said and just let people know, you know, some other insider things, how you've been a benefit for me because you manage my property.
Yeah.
Having a good property manager such as Brent has opened doors of opportunity for me to network with other great people, lawyers, real estate agents, other people in the industry. And he hedges my bets. Basically what he said was there are certain numbers I needed help with that he was able to help me with. And if you're new to this game, if you have the knowledge base of understanding the numbers, it gives you confidence to jump in.
Mm-hmm.
The ultimate thing I feel that you've done for me and what you can do for so many others is be that bridge between confidence and jumping in. So they're scared, they're nervous, but when they get with someone like you and that you have an understanding of what they want to do, you give them confidence to go ahead and get in because they're not alone, they're knowledgeable, and a lot of the things that they don't know yet, you've been able to provide them with, and that's what you've done for me. So that's a big plus to why you want to have a property manager. Now are you still currently owning this property management company? Are you sharing the chair with someone? Or are you doing it all on your own?
No, we have two offices.
Okay.
I have one business partner, and
okay,
I primarily run the office out of Winston-Salem.
Gotcha.
And then my business partner runs this office.
Okay.
So we represent the entire Triad area,
mm-hmm,
and we felt the two offices would give us better coverage. And
absolutely.
You know, we're.
But that's not the only hat you wear. Tell us about some of the other hats you wear besides just being a co-owner of the property management business.
Well, real estate has really changed my life. I'm really involved in multiple aspects of it. So obviously running the property management business, is a piece of it. I also work on the business development. So if you've got a property and or you're thinking about buying a property and you're investigating property management services, I would probably be the one to take that call and, and talk to that person.
Right.
We get all sorts of levels of you know, real estate education. Some people inherited a property yesterday, and then some strategically bought a property to be an investment. So, you know, we talk to people in the whole spectrum of knowledge and things like that. So, and then I'm still actively, you know, investing. I've still got investment properties, and I practice what I preach. And you know, I feel like I'm in the trenches out there, just like a lot of other people trying to better themselves and better their lives.
Absolutely.
So that's been fun too.
And what you just said, I think, is key to one of the questions I would tell my subscribers to ask a property management company: is anyone who's in ownership still actively investing? You've got to want to know that they're doing that, because they understand the climate that you're trying to do. They know what your goals are. They know what kind of goals you're striving for, because they're actively doing it as well, which means that their skills are always sharp. They can always give you the best type of guidance going forward. And to get you out of here, I like to do something we call the Life Gains Round. These are two important questions, basically about you and how this the positive impact real estate has had in your life. And so one question I always like to ask anyone doing what you do is, what is your favorite business book or real estate book, or both if you've got to?
Okay. I think that the one that really opened my eyes to what is possible with passive income was Robert Kiyosaki's Rich Dad Poor Dad. That is a fantastic book as far as just shifting your mindset on ways to make money.
Gotcha.
And what to spend your time on. As you think about your whole process in life and starting out, maybe just getting out of school, to trying to figure out what you want to do, to whatever your goal is in retirement or spending your time or whatever.
Absolutely.
So that was helpful for me. I think the other book is just an old classic. It really is more of it's not a specific real estate book, but it's more of a mindset development and thought process book, and that's Think and Grow Rich.
Yeah.
Napoleon Hill.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly, the book's probably over 100 years old now.
I mean, I think that's a favorite of everybody in this field.
It's timeless, and it just helps you prioritize, and it's just a collection of study of some very successful people in life, and you can pull nuggets from that and be able to, you know, hopefully implement some of that in your own life. And, you know, I try to reread it every 4 or 5 years and have found it very helpful.
Absolutely. Last life gains question of this round. Real estate has created a passive income. You have a portfolio yourself. With having that passive income, it allows you a little bit more flexibility. Having said that, what are some of your favorite hobbies or pastimes you do because this passive income has created you the opportunity to do different things in your life?
Well, that's an interesting question. Well, I'll start off by saying that, you know, I got a few gray hairs here, but not a lot. So
look a day past 42. Stop it.
So I still feel like I'm somewhat young. I do have 4 young children, so they keep me up, and that's probably how I'm getting these gray hairs. but honestly, I'm still developing the passive income in just a pure investment form. So I'm not, you know, spending it, you know, overspending and things like that. To a point, I'm really still trying to develop it and grow it.
Right.
And, you know, but as far as hobbies, I guess, you know, with the 4 kids, I don't have very many, but.
Sounds like the kids are the hobby.
Yeah, they are. You know, they're sporting events and activities. And
right.
They're sometimes I think I'm a professional bus driver or something, you know, with taking them everywhere. But, you know, to answer your question, I think one thing, I do enjoy sports. I think as time goes on, I'd love to go to more live events.
Right.
You got the Panthers hat on. I'm a Panthers fan. I'd love to be able to, you know, go to some of the games and maybe travel to some of the away games. Mm-hmm. That would be a lot of fun. I think at present, one hobby that I have is football cards. So, you know, some of the higher end players from when I was probably in high school and early 2000s and things like that, I really follow the industry. It's big on eBay now, and so that's one area that it's just a hobby. It's not a business or anything, but I, you know, I do enjoy investing in that as well. and probably would love to get into that more over time. It's just, right. To me, it's fun.
Well, you know, I still got all my basketball and football cards from when I was in high school, which was like 96, 95.
Okay.
I honestly have 102 different Michael Jordan basketball cards, and I still got one of those rare rookies that only 300 people have. I've got one of them.
Oh, I'd like to talk to you about
that.
And
I've got some football and baseball cards I've kept too, so I wouldn't say it's a hobby for me. I've just held on to it.
Okay.
And I kept them in pristine condition.
Ooh,
so,
okay.
Last question to get you out of here. For anyone that's trying to reach you, how can they reach you?
Well, our company name is Real Property Management, mm-hmm. of the Triad.
Right.
And so we are a franchise, and we have two locations, one in Greensboro, one in Winston-Salem. And people are welcome to email me, mm-hmm. brent@rpmtriad.com, mm-hmm. brent@rpmtriad.com. And then our website is www.rpmtriad.com. And so you can see a little bit about us on there. But feel free to reach out if you got a question or investigating the industry. It's a lot of fun. But I think that, you know, real estate's a team sport.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you've got to have different team members to help, you know, drive that Lamborghini. And
absolutely.
Property management's just one of them.
Absolutely.
You know, we talked about that a minute ago. You know, you've got an attorney, a surveyor,
agent, yeah.
You know, an inspector, sales agent, you know, all these different people can give you little pieces of advice to help you, you know, succeed with what you're trying to accomplish.
Absolutely.
And so I would be glad to talk to anybody out there that is interested in the industry or ready to get something started or thinking about it, whatever. We've got a good pulse here of what's happening in the marketplace.
Absolutely.
We have to. You know, our owners ask questions, and we've got active investors looking to buy more properties. So we, you know, they ask us what they're, you know, what we think. And so we need to be prepared to answer those questions.
Yeah. And believe me, ladies and gentlemen, no one has asked this man more questions than a 5-year-old toddler than me. I've been riding him hard, and he's given me solid, productive answers every time. Mr. Brent, thank you for your time.
You're welcome. It's been
and
fun.
Just like he said, ladies and gentlemen, every team has got to have LeBron James, Magic Johnson, Tom Brady, Cam Newton, and for me, the property manager, which is him, has been that for my team. That's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like my video. Please comment and subscribe. Go get yourself that life gain. If you need to catch Brent, all his links will be in the video description. You want to get going in real estate, need that confidence booster, give him a call. He'll let you know what's going on. And until our next sexy as hell video, we'll see you.